It's about 5:30 in the morning, and we are in preparation of getting the pig.
Lechan.
Yeah, it take about 5 hours, and then they're gonna make fritada. Yeah. So they're making a fire now. Yeah, kita kan long alder ni. Ya se bolon dor tiang e mo nya magalavi pinirni e mori omlu e mo ya fitala ha era un paride the some boy cleaning the pipe e sel pipe di bom boban di ka mo sure ngal babi en dan te natieren aan de man op is. En dan gaat ons aan een gil waar wie. Kamang terpaya.
Belum kemain itu.
Lagi terlole. Emuraran merale ostar. Latirakir nama tu jumpa terlomps. Jadi ke 5:45 berarti tahu. Sel kerja makan dengan nyama dapat. Da music la loro lì e me lo voglio chiamare sta a fare la old day to day non è a fare io la frate era della Imelda la domanda a voi io era Imelda and this is around their house and this is the house.
Oi. espanyol.
Ay, ay! Friend! Gamara tita span na kung kayo kagama dito ang kinang.
Span, friend!
Matapala
mo kinang
na.
Friend, span!
Ah, doa! Dapat
kinang na nga. Ano, span, kini kay kay film!
Ang pinapanan ko na ni Gloria, kaya pinapan na mo eh. Pinapan na
dahil. Span, kini kay
kay kay kay kay
kay kay kay kay
Thank you.
jalon upari tembura babi de lagi upari
for next 5 hours. Next 5 hours to turn, and after that, party time. Kita lom lagi kel, kel sosir ni marobu teori lah elasi berapa lagi.
Jessie Man, you come.
Hello.
Okay, take a picture of Brent. Now Brent. Brent is 10 years old and now it's gonna turn. Okay, Brent. Thank you.
Now 3 hours later, and here's how it looks. Now, and we got 2 more hours to go.
Bye bye.
2 more hours, sir.
Hmm?
2 hours.
Okay. Take it to the number one. Number one, lang aki. Pinagiling yung bibig ni mo ni Jan. Pari ra, adarada imenta ma.
Sige ba kung ano yung pinagiling yung
This in is Christina.
Sadar, you taste it.
You taste it.
You taste it. Yeah. Yeah.
That's good.
Oh, and you know,
I'm going to go to the house.
Sabi pa lang naman ang pagtagilan. Dedi kay tu kumaje je ti kalu kuma ru ma. Dedi kay mura na ngay ni tu ku ja ba. Pagi pa lang.
That's a pig.
Oh, it's a lechon. Ni ba mi?
That's Amboy's sister, and that's.
That's Amboy's mother. L'experiència que hagi decorat l'eta de rato a dudir portar l'on a l'itxen ordre regarà o que el tumul mei sola et el manga tema mingi tacle to ngara i que el viri racer se mergo de mei e mei to mingi tacle gara o que mingi babi ya mara imli il bia ma khalil mit tirga gi de ma okay this is Marlin kitchen Marlin Mendez's mother and she's cooking been cooking all this morning until now yeah there she is and the fritada has been prepared also those are tilapia yeah tilapia nasi right now we just got pinapit what's that pinapit yeah pinapit yeah fritada is coming up they're cooking it outside right. And there's Mr. Aban Lam di tinggal babi ini lah. Kamu sup, kamu ekor yang lari ori.
Dan dasar bikin sakit. Esta que tal vez mi ano yo ya quisare lejos, muy lejos de ti. Bésame.
You are the thing about their station.
Bésame mucho. Como si fuera esta noche la punta de mi piel. Bésame, bésame mucho. Pues tengo miedo perderte, perderte a después.
I'm gonna put up a prize. Whoever scores the highest will win the prize. Okay? Okay. So drink some more beer and then. I'm his name.
bluer than blue, sadder than sad. You're the only light the sand through has ever had. Life without you is gonna be
in the name of God, we pray.
count. I'm going already. That don't count. Okay. Okay, one, who else want to challenge that? Because if not, you know, Osame family with the first, second, and third prize. Yeah. Who wants to challenge Osame's family?
Ni mama, ay ba niyo ni mamangin?
What's your mom?
Mamahal. Tatakan
niya lang.
She's still eating.
I'm
still eating.
We need to have her. She beat Amboy. She beat Amboy.
You are the one first. Mamahal.
Can I challenge
Not behind. No, there's no way.
That's
the
one.
No
way. I will make 101.
Cannot. Abu's father already number one, the wife number two, that way. Osame family, singing family.
The singing family.
Who else? Nobody wants to challenge, so I pay.
How about you, Angel?
Osame family, wait.
Hey, Carol.
Hello, maybe they are talking to you. Yo, Palanto.
But I'm living right and being free. We don't make party out of loving. But we like more the hands pitching moves. We don't lay our heads for glowing shaggy. Francisco, dude. And I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee. A place when even sways the pebble ball. We still play for glory down at the courthouse. The college dean. And I'm proud to be an Okie from Muskogee. Place where the even sways and never more. We still wave a pony down at the courthouse. And white lightning to the face of rainbow. Oh, my God.
He's a good
singer. Him and the wife are good singers.
I found my pillow.
Hey!
Yeah. On your arm and tender body, like the mine. Hear the whisper of the raindrop, blowing soft against the window. And
somebody.
Good morning to you, ma'am. This lady here is the mother of owner of this resort, and this, you know, we came to eat breakfast, and she was here. It's the first time I've seen her, and she's been telling us a lot of story, different stories, how they were raised, and her daughter owns this resort here. And also, she's got three doctors, MD, that are in the United States practicing medicine there. And I'm going to ask her, what is the secret of being a successful businesswoman? Ma'am, you know, I see this resort here belongs to your daughter, you said. And how did you start? And what's the secret of becoming a successful businesswoman?
Well, before, when I was young, I was not able to reach college because of our financial problems. Now that I have six children, the oldest is a doctor, she's in state. The second is a boy, Lawrence, who owns the total gas station. And the third is Norma, who is in the States also.
Yeah.
This is a CPA. And then the fourth is Norbert, who owns the rice mill. The fifth is Grace, who is also a doctor. This is state. My youngest is Gertrude, who owns this.
I see.
And I thank God that all my children are successful.
I see.
because of my
hard work.
Hard working. I am a hard working mother.
Yeah. Yeah.
And my husband passed away year 1953.
I see.
And then.
So that time, 1953. That time, your children are still very young.
Yeah.
So you raised them by yourself?
Yes.
I see. And now they're all successful.
Yes.
Today you're 81 years old.
Yes.
And you're still very healthy. You know, what's the secret of being healthy? What do you eat every day? Most of the food that you eat.
Well, every day I work hard. Not so much, but. I always eat vegetable.
What kind of vegetable?
Like ampalaya.
Argoso.
Talo. Saluyot. Saluyot. And then I cook pirakbet and then mix it with a little pork. And
but you don't eat meat. How often you eat meat?
Sometimes. 3 times a week, like that.
Yeah, 3 times a week.
Yeah. Yeah.
But very small. Not much meat.
Not much.
Oh, I see.
Maybe about 3-4 slices, is enough.
Ah, I see, I see.
And then I eat in the morning breakfast. I eat egg, sunny side up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A cup of coffee.
Uh-huh.
And then a little bread. That's all.
Uh-huh. You, and how's your vision? Your eyes okay and you hear okay?
Yes.
You're still okay. It must be hard. It was so hard to raise how many children?
Six children.
Yes. And they're all very successful.
Yes.
So, you know, I don't know how you did that. What's the secret of to become a successful? What is the secret that you did?
That part?
A secret. What is it that you did that made you a very successful?
Like this. When my children were young, when they were in the grade school, grade yeah. one, like that, and then I always tell them to study hard.
Study hard.
To help me work in the house. After coming from school, they put their books on the table and they'll help me in the store, sell, and then arrange my goods like that. And after that, we eat lunch.
I see.
After eating lunch, maybe 30 minutes, they go to school again.
I see.
1:30. Then they come back at 4, then they help me again in the store. My children always help. They do not go and play.
Who helped you to start the store? Your husband start the store with you?
Yeah, my husband before, but he passed away. Then I was the one who managed it.
So you manage the store?
Yes.
And raise your children?
Yes.
I see. And they turn out to be 3 out of 6 are doctors and a successful businesswoman.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're all successful.
Yes, really. Thank God.
So there's a secret of how you save money. What do you say? Don't spend so much.
Yes.
Okay.
Like this. If I earn a peso, maybe I will spend the 40 pesos or 30 like that. Very economical. And then I save the rest.
You save the rest.
I keep the rest for my children.
Then, I see.
When how many years? As years goes by, my savings is accumulated.
I see. So I think the rule of thumb is like me. I say if I never spend, if I earn $1 a day, I again only spend 50 cents or 30 cents to 50 cents at the most. But I spend 30 cents and then I save the rest.
Yeah.
So, a lot of people are spending their money before they earn it on credit.
Yeah.
And yeah. Yeah. And the Americans have, it's a, our typical, you know, people, Americans are very, you know, they believe of getting something on credit and take 5 years, 6 years to pay for it. But I think it's safe to buy something, save for it, and then buy. That's what I do. I like to save and buy instead of going to the bank and get a loan, buy a car. Yeah. So now you raise your children. They after school they come, and then help you and run the store. I saw that building downtown. That's your building, right?
Five stories.
Yeah, that's your building. And you started from selling with small store. Eh?
Very small. Yeah. Small store.
Yeah, very small. Yeah.
And then after that, when my children were studying in college in Manila, and then I earned money, I bought some rice field.
I see.
Rice field. You know rice field?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I bought rice field in Gilamot.
Lamot Ifugao.
Lamot Ifugao.
That's a cheaper.
I bought around 30 hectares.
I see.
And then I managed the how planting and the harvesting.
Yeah.
And then I enjoy it. Mm-hmm. But my children said, "Don't work anymore, Mama. You're already old." But
you enjoy doing it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They don't let me work, but I enjoy working.
Mm.
I feel sick if I do not work.
His father
stayed with me.
Uh-oh.
He's a good guy.
Oh, Imelda's father.
Yeah, uh-oh. He's a driver, and I touch him.
Mm, I see. And now you retire, you just here to help your daughter, but... when you don't do anything, you feel sick.
Yeah,
eh?
Really.
You want to get up and do something.
Yes.
That
is a custom.
Yeah, yeah. Even me, you know, I'm 60. I'm going to 61 next this coming November, and if I don't do something all day, in the evening when I face my food, I ask myself, what did I do? What, you know, and I feel sick, you know.
We have the same problem.
Yeah, yeah. But I think to be successful, you have to set your own policy, like I earn $1, I will only spend 30 cents, and the rest goes to savings.
Yeah.
And when you have that much, you know, you can invest your money by buying a rice field or a building or a store, whatever. But, you know, it's so, you know, I'm so happy that I came here and talked to your daughter. I just passed by and I saw the sign, so I stopped and talked to her, and she said, "Well, we have rooms if you want to stay." So I said, "How much?" "In 800 for those single bed, and then 1,200 for the one that I got with two beds, and they're very nice room. They're very nice room, you know. So maybe I'll invite my friends to come."
Yeah.
And,
yeah. Well, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. You know, thank you for this short interview, and this is going to be shown on my television. So it's good advertisement also for your daughter's resort. Palestine?
Palestine,
the name of the resort. Yeah, and it's really nice. You got tilapia down here and tropical fish.
You can go swimming there at the back.
Yeah. We toured the whole place. Uh-huh. Yeah, I went there and saw the swimming pool. And looks like this place was a rice field.
It was a rice field before, but they completed it like this.
Yeah.
Then the owner was not able to
maintain it.
Then they sold it to my daughter. And my daughter was the one who
fixed it up good.
Yeah.
I see. That's really, now it's good. You know, like Imelda suggested to your daughter to advertise on the internet, you know, and said, you look located in Barabac and Nueva Vizcaya, and the telephone number, and then reservation. We can make a reservation.
Yeah, good.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Well, thank you so much.
Okay. Thank you too.
Okay. Nueva Vizcaya capital. Oh. And it's a very nice place. It's We're right in the middle of typhoon, but as you can see, yeah, the wind is start blowing now. Typhoon is scheduled to pass through here sometime today. That's a very nice place, Nueva Vizcaya. This is St. Mary's University, where Imelda used to go to school. And this is the school. This is the school where, this is the university where Imelda went to school. Yeah, and this is the town. This is the town where she was staying. Yeah, this is the town where she was staying and go to school here. Imelda used to go to school here.
How are you?
I'm tired.
So you just came from Palau? Sabali talaga dito may chicken na. Ngayon ba siya? Ha? Then,
ay, mabali?
The president and the Trump University chaplain just...
Okay, this is, we just came inside, you know, the main supervisor happens to know Imelda, she went to school here.
This is the Reverend Thomas G. Gymnasium.
Uh-huh.
And this is also the old library.
And that's a new building there. That's a new building over there, right?
Yes, Reverend Roger Chole building.
Uh-huh. Okay, and this is the St. Mary's University, where Imelda and also Teresa went to school.
Yes.
In Solano.
I'm from Solano too.
Oh, you're from Solano?
Yeah, Suarez family.
Okay. Just want to take a picture of the university, so I can go back and show it to Teresa, Imelda's sister.
Yeah. This is the new, the latest library. This is the new library.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Very nice. It's really nice.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
If you could just drop in front of the new building,
yeah,
the administration building, you get that. And that building is the chapel.
Okay, it's typhoon time. Yeah, so there's no school today because the typhoon, as you can see. Yeah.
This is the administration building.
This is the administration building, okay.
Four pillars, and
so that's the field. Okay, this is the administration building, right? Nice university, Imelda.
Yeah.
Number 9. It's St. Mary's and the university, a main office.
I'm silent. Digama ma manage the tiang and the Malaysia Singapore. What's the name of this?
Saint Dominic Cathedral. Saint Dominic Cathedral.
Saint Dominic. Cathedral. Oh, Saint Dominic Cathedral. Right there. In Bayombong in Nueva Vizcaya. Say it. One of the oldest. How old is this church, Imelda? Beautiful, good to view. Very nice, eh? Okay, again, this is the history of this church. It said on Sunday, April 12, 1739, the first mass was celebrated by Fray Pedro Freire, OSA, in the Church of St. Augustine in Bayombong. And on September 8, 1739, the Augustinians seated this mission to the Dominicans and we dedicated the church to the Saint Dominic de Guzman. From 1773 to 1792, Fray Juan Crespo constructed the church, the octagonal tower, the convent, and the cemetery next to the church in bricks. In 1798 to 1806, and from 1820 to 1829, Father Juan Malano added the fifth story of the tower and the cone above it. And in 1880, the church was damaged by the killer earthquake, but not the tower. And on November 15, 1982, Messenger Alberto van Overbeek, CICM, became the first bishop of the diocese of Bayombong. Kagida bibira ablay ngar del el suburb ra Bayombong. Gidre lang a abli lang del maasil dalala abila a brother ra Imelda. Agin ni mas. Yang gak mandi mungkin dia email dah siang ngah school. Mister Talme yang ni mesti visit tu. Ang isolan, Korea typhoon mai ga gi dal le la li se soal melo ot alu le sun se sai ot la e la ki nga ra condition 3 ra condition 3 mana sa ot un di melo wa pe aba kai sub se ko ma pe ko tengel Adelom. Ini visit tiga lagi del couple semana yang saura email dar al ngara college. Nolai. Ida igal kapal kar kamahungan. Susah.
Kumut kapailan